Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to solve a numerical which is based on Gibbs free energy change, and let us see that how can we solve that, because we are going to solve different kind of numericals. So we are now going to do the first among them. So this is a question which is based on Gibbs free energy change. So first of all, what they have asked is that we have to calculate the free energy change at 298 Kelvin for the reaction at 298 Kelvin. The Br2 plus Cl2, that is this two, are being given to and as a reactant, and which is giving us 2 moles of BrCl. And in this case, the delta H or the change in enthalpy, it has been found to be that is 39.3 kilojoule. And the entropies of the Br2, that is bromine, chlorine and BrCl, are 15152.3 as well as 223.0 and 239.7 respectively for Br2, for Cl as well as for BrCl. And in this case, this all data are been given, and from which we have to calculate what would be the free energy change. So first of all, let us do the extraction of the data from the given question, and let us analyze later that which kind of formula and which formula will be used, because Gibbs free energy has different formulas, so we have to apply various formulas in that. So let us analyze that later, but first of all, let us calculate or let us predict what are the given data given to us. So first of all, they have provided us the temperature, so therefore the given data consists of temperature, which has been mentioned as 298 Kelvin. And later on, what they have given us, they have provided us the reaction, and the reaction is nothing but, as you could, I'll show you later on. But in this case, the delta H is also been provided to us. It has been basically 339.3 kilojoule. So this is the enthalpy that they have provided us, but this is kilojoule, so I have to convert it into joule, because for a better convenience I will convert it into joules. So therefore 39.3 into 10 raised to 3 joules that I have written here. So this is the value of delta H, and along with that they have given us the entropies of the reactants as well as for the product. So in this case, I would write here the entropies of the reactant. The first reactant has been given to as bromine molecule, so therefore S of, that is entropy of bromine molecule, has been given to be, that is 152.3 joule per mole per Kelvin. And talking about the later, that is for chlorine, the entropy has been provided to be, that is 223.0 again joule per mole per Kelvin. And for BrCl, that is, they have given us, that is 239.7 joule per mole per Kelvin. So in this case, this is the thing that they have provided to us. But as they have also mentioned the reaction, so from the reaction, what we are going to do is we can predict what would be the change in entropy. How? Because the reaction has been given to us, that is bromine plus chlorine, this both reactant will give us 2 moles of BrCl. Therefore, the change in entropy can be calculated easily. How? We have the formula, that is, the change in entropy of a system is nothing but the summation of entropies of the product minus the summation of entropies of the reactants. But talking about the product what we have is, that is, 2 moles of that is BrCl, so therefore the entropy of BrCl minus the summation of the reactant molecules that we have. So in this case, what we have is 1 mole of Br2, so therefore nothing to multiply with any number, it will be just as the same, that is entropy of Br2 plus 1 mole of Cl2 has been represented in the reactant side, so therefore again entropy of Cl2 I would write here. So the thing that I have to do is I have to substitute the values over here, so therefore, so for BrCl, the value that has been given to us is basically 239.7, and that of the bromine, that is Br2, that has been given as 152.3, and that of the chlorine molecule, that has been given as 223.0. So this is the value that we have substituted here, and let us see what is the answer or what is the change in entropy that we will get here. So we have got a value of 104.1, and now in this case the change in entropy will be, basically the unit will be the same, that is joules per mole per Kelvin. So this is the value of delta S that we have got. But among the Gibbs free formula that we know, that Gibbs free for Gibbs free energy has different formula, that is when it has a relationship with the enthalpy, as well as when it has a relationship between the equilibrium constant. So in this case, as we could see that the delta H has been also been provided to us, as well as here we could see that the entropy, the change in entropy, it is also been calculated along with the temperature has been also mentioned. So in this case, only one formula has been there that we could substitute or where we could use in this given question, so as to calculate the desired, that is free energy change, and that is, we know that delta G is equals to delta H minus T delta S. So this is what we have, and now in case of the delta H that we have, that is we have calculated the or we have analyzed in joules, that what would be the value of the change in enthalpy, and it was found to be 39.3, that is into 10 raised to 3 joules, it was been mentioned over there, minus the temperature that has been provided to us is 298 Kelvin. So therefore 298 Kelvin into the entropy. The change in entropy that has been calculated to be, that is 104.1. So now what we are going to do, we are going to solve this sum, and let us see what is the value of delta G that we have got. So we have got a value of 8278.2. And now the thing is, because H is a kind of energy, that is enthalpy, and enthalpy are denoted by joules, and even T delta S is nothing but the joules itself, it will come in joules itself, so therefore the overall answer would be joules. So therefore this is the value of delta G that we have got. And in this case, the delta G, or we could say the Gibbs free energy, has been said to be positive. So this indicates that the reaction that we have, or that has been provided to us, is basically a non-spontaneous reaction. So this is how we have calculated the value of the Gibbs free energy change. Very much easy to calculate. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have got to know that how this kind of numericals are to be solved. So I hope you are going to solve this kind of numerical more and more, and share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.